Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Aggie Greys' famous Samoan family has expanded its business empire into Tahiti.
The family has just bought a hotel in the capital, Papeete, propelling the Grey dynasty into international waters. Barbara Jeeva with this report.
The life of the late Aggie Greys is the stuff legends are made of, and there are a fair few attached to her name, all of them lured by the South Pacific and ending up at Aggie's famous Samoan hotel.
Well, we've had Gary Cooper, Marlon Brando. Missioner was my friend. He used to call in to the hotel.
Born in 1897, Aggie Grey started her business as a widow during World War II.
I started the club with 18 bottles of beer, a bottle of whiskey, and a bottle of gin. And little by little, I got on. I had to stop the club because there was no more liquor.
And then during this last war, I started the hotel.
While she had her fans, it was author Willard Price who dubbed her Bloody Mary, the feisty character from the musical South Pacific, after she refused him a room. Ironically, it was after his unflattering comparison was published in a Vancouver paper that her fame grew.
You know, sexy like Lieutenant.
Did me more good, but sometimes it hurts when they keep at it, you know, because I first saw the picture Bloody Mary in Wellington here years ago, where Bloody Mary was trying to sell her daughter for $4.
Several decades and two generations later, her grandson Fred is making waves of his own.
It's a great legacy for Aggie. It's, you know, taking the brand to that next level. It's growing the brand, it's getting the name out there.
Taking it to the next level has meant dramatically expanding the Aggie Grey brand and entering into top tourism market Tahiti. Fred Grey has just bought this property, the multi-million dollar Le Meridian Hotel.
I think the Aggie Greys brand coming to Tahiti in such a aggressive and prominent way, and I've sensed just since I've arrived here that the community was I think in shock and awe in the beginning, you know, to think, well, a Samoan's coming and he's buying such a big and established resort in Papeete, and they're sort of saying to themselves, well, you know, gee, that's strange. We didn't know Samoans were that prominent in the field or that sophisticated in terms of their economic and investment portfolios.
For the Grey family, there's more than just business at stake.
She'd be very proud, my grandmother. She taught me a lot of things. She taught me how to drive, how to fish, how to sail. So a lot of things that I wasn't taught, she taught me. So she'd be very proud, and I know she was an aggressive woman. It's a proud day.
6 years ago, the family answered the Samoan government's request to build the country's first resort. They then agreed to a joint airline venture. The government owns 49% of Virgin Samoa and the Greys 2%. The family is also a major partner at the exclusive Sinalei Resort and more recently has gone into the bottled water business. Fred Grey says the time is right to make a move internationally.
I guess with the tsunami that hit Samoa in 2009, that was very devastating for Samoa. It was very devastating for tourism. So I guess it made us look elsewhere. Tahiti has great potential tourism-wise.
You know, the opportunities in our market have become more restricted. They're more limited now, but you know, here there's a more unlimited potential here in Tahiti.
They see the recently renovated Le Meridian as the key. Fred Grey believes the property, which is set on a white sand beach with overwater bungalows, is a winner. He's hoping its location and features will attract Australian and New Zealand tourists, which is the second largest growth market in Tahiti.
The property that came up and suits the Aggies brand is this one. It's central, it's near the airport. It's near all the shops, it's near everything, and I guess the perception that that a lot of New Zealanders and Australians have about Tahiti is expensive. So we want to try and change that perception. We want to
say Tahiti is actually affordable.
As well as catering to tourists, it's also about the locals. The hotel boasts a gallery where artists can work and display the results. While the new owner may be Samoan, the hotel is firmly Tahitian.
It's Tahitian, no? So we want to keep it that way.
The Grey family is even closely working with the Tahitian government and negotiating with Virgin Australia for a direct flight from Australia.
How does a Samoan boy get to go international?
A lot of hard work, and still a lot of hard work ahead of me.
So as I said to Fred, I don't think it matters where you go in the world. We know that Aggie, wherever she is, that name Aggie Grey will always bring a reflected glory back to Samoa and to Samoans.
Fred Grey carries the weight of a family entwined with Samoa's history, but his eye is firmly fixed on the future.
Oh, it looks like all that hard work is finally paying off.
Great family success story there as well.
Definitely.